Hey, welcome back. In this video, we will review some common mistakes that even experienced developers can make when writing TypeScript code. So grab your favorite snack and let's go. The first mistake that you should take care of is the use of any instead of unknown. Using any is like going in a blind date without asking anything before. You never know what you're gonna get. Basically, if you annotate a variable or property or function argument as any, you are escaping the type safety offered by TypeScript. TypeScript will no longer check that variable. Instead, if you use unknown, TypeScript will show you an error if you are trying to do something weird with that variable. For example, if you annotate a variable as unknown and try to access to a property, TypeScript will tell you that this is not an object. So keep that in mind, use unknown before any. Next up is the idea of using type assertions instead of type declarations. This is like trying to fix a flat tire with duct taping. This is lying to TypeScript. This is not type safety because what you are saying is forcing certain value to become a type you decide. Type declaration instead, this thing with the two columns after the variable name, are a way to ensure that the value that you'll assign to that variable is the type you need. So always use type declarations instead of type assertions. The third common mistake that a lot of people does in the first days with TypeScript is using the function type instead of actually typing the function. The function type is a catch-all that allows any function to be assigned to that variable or property, but it doesn't give you any information about the type or shape of the function. Like there is no parameter definition, no return time, etc. To avoid this situation that is very similar to using any for variables, you are saying any function here, is to actually write the type of the function, being specific with the parameters types and the return type of that function. Another common mistake, the fourth mistake in this list, is not using the type utilities or actually repeating yourself, not using basic data transformation utilities to keep you dry. This is a recipe for disaster in two realms. It will be unmaintainable at some point because you are duplicating code all over the place. And the second thing is that sometimes you have types that are related, but if you are duplicating properties, you cannot keep this type in sync. TypeScript provides many utility types like pick, omit, exclude, etc. that can be used to create new type based on a previous existing type. This helps you to keep your code more readable and maintainable. If you're getting any value of this video, give a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Or basically, to avoid this mistake, learn and use the basic utility type for data transformation. A similar mistake to the previous one about not using the utility types is to repeat properties among related types. Repeating the same properties or value types among different interfaces or types will lead to code duplication and to hard to maintain code. To avoid this problem, use inheritance for interfaces or intersection for types. The idea here is to reuse whatever code you already wrote. Another common mistake is to actually not read the errors, and this is even outside of TypeScript world. One of the common errors beginners have when coding in general is to not read the errors. The errors tell you exactly what to do. Okay, I know, TypeScript errors are not fun and really hard to read, but it's a good practice to start understanding what the errors want to tell you. And most of the time, TypeScript errors can be read from bottom to top, and at the bottom, it will tell you exactly what you need to do. By understanding the error messages and how to interpret them, you'll be able to fix your issues with TypeScript, but also it allow you to search in a better way the solution for your problem. And in case you're still having troubles reading the TypeScript error, there is a nice VS Code extension named Total TypeScript by Matt Pocock that translates the errors to a more human-friendly way. So check that out. And the final mistake that I want to take note here is not using the strict mode. TypeScript can be configured in many different ways, and one of that way is to not using the strict mode. A strict mode enforce a stricter type checking, catching more errors and avoiding more mistakes. That ends up creating a more reliable code. So to avoid this mistake and also catch many bugs and even avoid some of the previous mistakes, enable a strict mode from start. So there you have it, 7 common mistakes that most TypeScript beginners or programmers happen to do and how to avoid them. So remember, use unknown instead of any, use the data transformation utilities like pick, omit, exclude, etc. Use a strict mode, learn to read the error messages, don't duplicate the properties, use type declaration instead of type assertions, don't use the function type, instead use a specific function declarations, and you'll be able to write better types of code and learn even more. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did it, hit that like button at the bottom and don't forget to subscribe to more content like this. And also YouTube is a very good recommendation engine and they think this video here will be good for you. So check that out. I'm pretty sure it will be awesome. See you in the next one.